Hey, thanks for joining us today. We are looking at 20 questions on the Fair Housing Act. This is an extremely important section of your exam. I hope you do well. Before we get started, I hope you subscribe to our channel. It's completely free. Hit the notification button. And if you like this kind of content, hit the thumbs up. Thanks. So question number one, what is the primary purpose of the Fair Housing Act? A, to establish property tax rates. B, to promote fair competition in the real estate market. C, to prevent discrimination in housing based on certain protected characteristics. And then D, to regulate property maintenance standards. Answer C, to prevent discrimination in housing based on certain protected characteristics. The Fair Housing Act aims to eliminate housing discrimination based on race, color, religion, sex, national origin, family familial status, and disability. Which of the following is not a protected characteristic under the Fair Housing Act? A, sexual orientation. B, race. C, disability. D, religion. A, sexual orientation. While there are ongoing discussions about expanding protections, as of now, sexual orientation is not explicitly included as a protected characteristic under the Federal Housing Act. What federal agency is responsible for enforcing the Fair Housing Act? A, Federal Trade Commission. B, Department of Housing and Urban Development. C, Environmental Protection Agency. D, Federal Reserve Board. B, Department of Housing and Urban Development. HUD is the federal agency responsible for enforcing the Fair Housing Act and ensuring compliance with fair housing laws. Which of the following is an example of familial status discrimination under the Fair Housing Act? A, refusing to rent to a single individual. B, charging different rent based on income. C, denying housing to a pregnant woman. D, prioritizing military veterans for housing. C, denying housing to a pregnant woman. Familial status discrimination includes discrimination against families with children, including pregnant women. What is redlining in the context of fair housing? A, discriminating against individuals based on their political beliefs. B, denying housing loans or insurance in certain neighborhoods based on their racial or ethnic composition. C, charging higher rent for individuals with disabilities. D, refusing housing based on age. Answer B, denying housing loans or insurance in certain neighborhoods based on their racial or ethnic composition. Redlining involves the discriminatory practice of denying loans or insurance in certain neighborhoods, often based on the racial or ethnic makeup of those areas. Which of the following actions is considered a violation of the Fair Housing Act? Offering discounts based on income level, providing housing assistance to military veterans, refusing to rent to individuals with service animals, implementing a non-discriminatory occupancy policy. Refusing to rent to individuals with service animals. Refusing to make reasonable accommodations for individuals with disabilities, including service animals, is a violation of the Fair Housing Act. What is the maximum fine for a first-time violator of the Fair Housing Act if the case is heard in federal court? A. $10,000, B. $25,000, C. $50,000, D. There is no maximum fine. C. $50,000. The maximum civil penalty for a first-time violator in federal court is $50,000. So it helps us if you subscribe to our channel, gets this content out. So hopefully you'll subscribe. It's absolutely free. Just hit the notification button after you do so you don't miss any of our videos so you can pass that exam. I hope you do well. Thanks. What type of housing is exempt from the provisions of the Fair Housing Act? Rental apartments, owner-occupied buildings with four or fewer units, public housing projects. All housing is subject to the Fair Housing Act. Owner-occupied buildings with four or fewer units. Owner-occupied buildings with four or fewer units, single-family homes sold or rented by the owner without a broker, and housing operated by religious organizations are generally exempt from the Fair Housing Act. What is steering in the context of fair housing? Directing individuals with disabilities to specific housing units? Channeling home buyers or renters to or away from certain neighborhoods based on their race, color, religion, or other protected characteristics, offering preferential treatment to military veterans, negotiating lower rents for specific demographic groups. Channeling home buyers or renters to or away from certain neighborhoods based on their race, color, religion, or other protected characteristics. Steering involves directing individuals to or away from certain neighborhoods based on the protected characteristics or class. What is the primary goal of the Affirmative Fair Housing Marketing Plan? A. To prevent discrimination in housing. B. To promote diversity in neighborhoods. C. To facilitate economic development in low-income areas. D. To ensure fair competition among real estate professionals. To promote diversity in neighborhoods. The Affirmative Fair Housing Marketing Plan aims to promote fair housing practices by affirmatively marketing housing to all segments of the community. What does the term blockbusting refer to in the context of fair housing? A. Encouraging residents to organize neighborhood events. B. Using scare tactics to induce homeowners to sell their properties at lower prices. C. Promoting fair housing practices. D. Investing in low-income housing projects. Using scare tactics to induce homeowners to sell their properties at lower prices. Blockbusting involves creating fear among homeowners in a neighborhood about an impending change in the racial or ethnic composition, often to induce them to sell at lower prices. In the context of fair housing, what is a reasonable accommodation? A. A modification to existing rental units. B. A fee charged to cover administrative costs. C. A limit on the number of occupants in a rental property. D, a modification to the application process. A, a modification to existing rental units. A reasonable accommodation is a modification or adjustment to the rules, policies, practices, or services of housing providers that enables a person with a disability to use and enjoy the dwelling. Which of the following is a potential consequence for a person found guilty of violating the Fair Housing Act in a civil case? A, community service. B, imprisonment. C, injunction and monetary damages. D, loss of real estate license. Injunction and monetary damages. In a civil case, violators of the Fair Housing Act may be subject to injunctions, court orders to stop discriminatory practices, and monetary damages. Once again, if you like this type of content, please hit the like button, ask questions in the comments, or give us a good comment, something that helps the algorithm so our content gets out there so more people can pass their real estate exam. Thanks. What is the primary purpose of the Equal Credit Opportunity Act in the context of fair housing? A, to regulate property taxes. B, to prevent discrimination in lending based on certain protected characteristics. C, to establish building codes. D, to promote environmental conservation. B, to prevent discrimination in lending based on certain protected characteristics. The ECOA prohibits discrimination in lending based on race, color, religion, sex, national origin, marital status, age, or the receipt of income from public assistance programs. Which of the following is not a prohibited action under the Fair Housing Act? A, refusing to make reasonable accommodations for individuals with disabilities. B, providing preferential treatment to military veterans. C, advertising a property only to specific racial or ethnic groups. D, charging different rent based on familial status. B, providing preferential treatment to military veterans. While providing preferential treatment to military veterans may be subject to other regulations, it is not specifically prohibited by the Fair Housing Act. What term describes a practice of requiring higher down payments, interest rates, or fees based on an applicant's race, color, religion, sex, or other protected characteristics? A, steering. B, predatory lending. C, blockbusting. D, redlining. Predatory lending. Predatory lending refers to the unfair or abusive lending practices, including discriminatory practices based on protected characteristics. What is the term for the illegal practice of refusing to make mortgage loans or provide insurance in specific neighborhoods based on the racial or ethnic composition? A, blockbusting. B, steering. C, redlining. D, predatory lending. C, redlining. Redlining is the discriminatory practice of denying loans or insurance in certain neighborhoods based on the racial or ethnic composition. What is the role of testers in fair housing enforcement? A, to provide housing education to communities, B, to conduct investigation and file lawsuits against violators, C, to create advertising materials for real estate professionals, D, to evaluate property values for tax assessments. B, to conduct investigation and file lawsuits against violators. Testers are individuals who pose as home seekers to gather information about possible discriminatory practices and assist in fair housing enforcement. Which federal law amended the Fair Housing Act to include protections against discrimination based on disability? A, the Rehabilitation Act of 1973, B, Americans with Disabilities Act, C, Section 504 of the Rehabilitation Act, D, Fair Housing Amendments Act. D, Fair Housing Amendments Act of 1988. The Fair Housing Amendments Act of 1988 amended the Fair Housing Act to include protections against discrimination based on disability. In the context of fair housing, what is the purpose of the design and construction requirements? A, to ensure that new construction meets environmental standards, B, to promote energy efficiency in buildings, C, to ensure that new multifamily dwellings are accessible to individuals with disabilities, D, to regulate property maintenance. C, to ensure that new multifamily dwellings are accessible to individuals with disabilities. The design and construction requirements under the Fair Housing Act aim to ensure that new multifamily dwellings are designed and constructed to be accessible to individuals with disabilities. Well, thanks again for joining us. I hope you did well on that exam. Once again, if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. It really helps us out. It's free to do it. And then hit the notification button so you don't miss a video, and give us a likes up. And if you don't have any questions, well, then just, you know, make a comment, say thanks, or it really helps us out in the algorithm in YouTube. And if you do have a question, ask it in the comments, and we'll try our best to help you out. I hope you have a great day. I hope you do well on your exam.